Hey friends. Hey. What's going on?
We are discussing the rest of the 5-mark question. Can anyone explain about Herb's palsy?
Sure, Herb palsy, or Herb Duchenne paralysis, is one of the most common neurological birth injuries. It is caused by injury to the brachial plexus,
which is formed from the ventral rami of cervical nerves 5-8 and thoracic nerve 1. The brachial plexus innervates all muscles of the upper limb except the trapezius.
Herb palsy occurs when the upper trunk of the brachial plexus, comprising cervical nerves 5 and 6, are severed. Most commonly, the brachial plexus is injured by traction of the neck during delivery.
It usually occurs in macrosomic infants who needed to be pulled from the birth canal. This maneuver causes stretching of the brachial plexus, which may injure it.
However, brachial plexus injury can also result independently of shoulder dystocia, an average weighing neonates. Shall we move on to the next 5-mark?
Blood supply of spinal cord. The spinal cord is a collection of nerve tissue extending from the caudal aspect of the brainstem to the lumbar region of the spinal canal.
Arterial supply to the spinal cord is vital to supplement the high metabolic requirements of this nervous tissue. The arterial supply to the spinal cord is via 3 longitudinal arteries, the anterior spinal artery and the pair posterior spinal arteries.
Anterior spinal artery formed from branches of the vertebral arteries. They travel in the anterior median fissure.
And the posterior spinal arteries originate from the vertebral artery or the posteroinferior cerebellar artery. They anastomose with one another in the pia mater.
Although the anterior and posterior spinal arteries are longitudinal and extend the length of the spinal cord, blood to these spinal arteries reaches only up to the cervical segments of the spinal cord.
What is the next question? Describe the typical vertebra.
A typical vertebra will consist of a body, a vertebral arch, and 7 processes. The vertebral body forms the anterior part of each vertebrae. The vertebral body is fairly large, especially in the lumbar vertebra. The vertebral arch forms the posterior portion of each vertebra.
It consists of 4 parts, the right and left pedicles and the right and left lamini. Each pedicle forms one of the lateral sides of the vertebral arch.
The vertebrae protect and support the spinal cord. They also bear the majority of the weight put upon your spine. Can you say me the last 5-mark question?
Gluteus maximus is the last 5-mark question. The gluteus maximus is the most superficial gluteal muscle that forms the prominence of the gluteal region.
The gluteus maximus is the main extensor muscle of the hip. It is the largest and outermost of the 3 gluteal muscles and makes up a large part of the shape and appearance of each side of the hips.
It origin from later posterior surface of sacrum and coccyx, gluteal surface of ilium, thoraca lumbar fascia, sacrotuberous ligament. It insert into iliotibial tract, gluteal tuberosity of femur.
Its action is psi extension, psi external rotation, psi abduction, superior part, psi adduction, inferior part. We completed all the 5 marks. We will meet tomorrow. Bye.